with me today from VR Education. I'm joined by David Whelan. David, nice to see you. Good afternoon.
Good to see you again, Andrew.
Could you tell us a bit more here? Significant deal that you've announced this morning with HTC. Just tell us a little bit more about what's involved here.
Yeah, so this is two parts. We're absolutely delighted that HTC has invested strongly in the company, taken a significant position. We've been dealing with HTC over the past 5 years. This is a long-term relationship. And the amount of progress that we've seen, especially over the last 6 months, HTC have taken a huge interest. And really, they want to push out the platform along with their hardware, have it as a combined package. And they are going to be selling it very strongly in the Asian markets, where they have a strong business development, sales and marketing wing over there. So really, it's been an excellent announcement and an excellent day for VR Education.
I remember the last time you and I spoke, I think it was towards the end of March. Weren't they doing something as far as a virtual conference and using the platform then?
Yes, so HTC had a physical conference scheduled, which was supposed to be held on mainland China. And what happened literally a few weeks before that event was due to kick off, it was completely cancelled because obviously the widespread coronavirus. And I met the president of HTC China, a guy called Alvin Graylin, inside the Engage platform at a different event, an educators event. And we sparked up a conversation inside, and he said, look, would you be able to host our VIVE developer conference, which is a major conference where they would have 3,000 developers from all over the world invited to a physical location, and HTC would show them the new technology that they're releasing and talk about new software. And obviously that couldn't happen. So he said, the Engage platform, if you could handle it, we'd be delighted to bring that into virtual reality. And we turned it around very, very quickly. And we had a very successful event where we had 1,600 people registered and we had 1,000 concurrent users. And we had 1.1 million people watching the live stream, the majority of which were in mainland China. And one of the real key features which Engage had is we could connect people from mainland China to the rest of the world in a virtual experience. And it was very easy, very intuitive to set up, and you could communicate as if you were in the same room. And it was a really, really massive success.
Well, as far as how meaningful this tie-up with HTC is to VR Education, what numbers have you put out into the market?
Yeah, so we have a four-year deal with HTC for the China region, and they will be paying us 75 grand a quarter in euros. So it'll work out at over $1 million for the license of Engage. And there's also a revenue share with that as well. So it is a really good commercial deal, both for ourselves and for HTC.
And they have it's not just Asia or China focused for them, is it?
No, it's not. So in China, they will be one of the exclusive partners within China, but outside of China region, they are free to resell Engage services on a global scale. And again, we will be certainly leveraging the marketing wing and sales departments of HTC to help us push the platform forward.
And tell me a little bit more then, as far as their investment into VR Education, what is it, 3 million euros that they're putting?
Yes, 3 million euros. So they will receive 20% of the business for that investment. And they will also be placing a non-exec director on the board of VR Education. So, and we will have a very close relationship going forward. We'll have access to a lot of their technology very early on. So we can always ensure that we are one step ahead of any of the competition.
What will this cash enable you to do? What will you be using it for?
So we'll be further developing the Engage platform. It's actually hugely accelerated over the past 6 months because of the coronavirus. It's being used very, very widely right now at the moment. So there's lots of features that people have asked us, especially from enterprise and corporate clients. Our original focus was more in the education sector, but there's so much work available now in corporate in the corporate world for using collaborative tools. We're really changing some of the parameters of Engage to make sure that it's an easier onboarding for people in the corporate world.
Are you looking at some new experiences?
Yeah, so we do have an experience coming out later this year. It'll be Shuttle Commander on the Oculus Quest and also on the PC. That has been in development quite a while, but since the coronavirus, quite a lot of the traction for the company has been on the Engage platform, but this experience will be out later this year.
And since we spoke about end of March, a couple of months ago, how's business been?
It's been so, so busy. We've been hiring so many different people. We've about 10 open positions at the moment. We've business developer positions, we've programmer positions, we've customer relations positions as well. So it's been a huge, it's been a bit of a headache actually trying to hire so many people so quickly, especially in coronavirus where they cannot come to the office and have a face-to-face with us. We're doing everything remotely, but all of my team are working remotely through the Engage platforms. We hold all our daily stand-ups inside Engage. We hold all our meetings inside Engage as well. And we actually hold quite a lot of these interviews inside the platform. So if we're not using it, how can we sell it? And we have been using it on a daily basis. And 50% of my time now is actually inside virtual meetings.
And you've secured some additional deals?
Yeah, so we've secured a deal with a company in America called Victory XR. They're an education company. They have 180 lessons already tailor-made for the American education system. They're onboarding all their content to Engage, and are already providing remote classes to a lot of those schools who've been closed down because of the coronavirus. And we did also close another deal with a company called New Eyes, who trained the visually impaired people. And I know a lot of people might think, why would VR be very useful to visually impaired? Well, we have a spatial audio system, and a lot of these visually impaired won't be totally blind. They can still see shapes and objects, and they can experience these as they would in the real world, in a virtual world, the very same way. So it's quite an interesting way to use the platform, and something that I would not have foreseen in the past. And we're getting so many requests in from all different walks of life and all different types of businesses that we're seeing huge possibilities to expand the Engage platform in many different areas.
And I'd expect, as far as just going back to events for a moment, very unlikely there's going to be any actual physical events take place for the foreseeable future. That's forcing a lot of companies now to look at alternatives.
Yeah, because of the success of the VIVE Developer Conference, the HTC event, we've had so many large event organizers contact us looking to hold their own virtual events. And they've all come up against barriers with using video-based platforms where you can't have those hallway conversations. So if you're looking at an event on, say, Zoom as an example, and you have a crowd of 1,000 people, yes, you can watch the keynote talks, but where the majority of business is done at an event is when you meet someone in a hallway and you have that hallway conversation. Or you might meet a group of 4 or 5 people, and next thing you might be talking to the CTO of Qualcomm as an example. These are things that cannot happen on video-based platforms, and this is why people go to events, but they can happen inside the Engage platform at virtual events, because you have an avatar, you can move to a different location, you can go into a separate breakout room. All of this is enabled within virtual reality, and the Engage platform is front and center in many people's minds now, and we're just really catching up to try service all of this potential work that's coming down the road.
Well, clearly a lot happening, David. What news can we expect to hear from you next? What are you specifically working on at the moment?
Big news, that's what you can expect. So we've lots of stuff in the pipeline, and I'm super excited for what's going to happen over the next 6 months. So I would say to anybody watching this video, definitely just keep tuned and watch our Twitter feed for updates.
Well, hopefully we can speak again soon, David. Thanks very much.
No problem. Thank you, Andrew.